CIET-NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So friends, let's join in Dhwani Shala class 4.
Hello, myself Siddharth. Today we are here to learn chapter 1 of class 4th Maths Magic book. It is a NCERT textbook for class 4. We will going to discuss chapter 1, that is building with bricks. Today we will talk about bricks. Yes, you heard it right, bricks. You have seen bricks in walls, school building. Sometimes you have also seen brick design on floor, brick design on walls. Bricks are everywhere. Can you tell me the color of bricks? Yes, I want to know the color of bricks. Yes, bricks are red in color, sometimes dark red, sometimes lighter shade of red. Mostly bricks are red in color. Children, nowadays we can also see gray bricks. Gray bricks are also popular in current situation. Do you know why we use bricks in making our houses or making any building? What is the role of bricks? Tell me. Why we use bricks in making walls, in making houses, in making buildings? What is the role of bricks? Yes, you are right. Bricks give strength to our houses and buildings. And apart from giving strength, we have designs made with bricks on walls and on floors, which makes the building more beautiful. These floor patterns or wall patterns or design makes the building more beautiful. It adds beauty to the building or house. Have you seen any brick design in your house or any other building? Children, have you seen any brick design? I am sure that you have seen beautiful designs on floor and on walls. I have also seen beautiful brick floor design. I want to share it with you. I have a park near my house in which floor is covered with bricks. Bricks are making a beautiful design on it. In that design, in a line, three bricks are placed horizontally. Yes, in that design, three bricks are placed horizontally and three bricks vertically. Again, three bricks horizontally and three bricks vertically, and so on. Can you imagine the design? Listen carefully. Three bricks horizontally and three bricks vertically. Again, three bricks horizontally and three bricks vertically. I'm sure you have guessed the design. Yes, it is very beautiful. Mason makes these design or pattern to make floor more attractive and beautiful. I know you want to visit that park. Tell me, yes or no? Do you want to visit that park? Okay. Once the pandemic ends, we will visit that park together. I also saw one more brick pattern at my friend's house. I want to share it with you. Are you ready? Is it interesting? Okay, listen. His veranda floor has a beautiful pattern. In this design, bricks are arranged in V shape. Two bricks are inclined to each other so that we can see English alphabet V in them. Children, if you join your heels and open your toes, which shape you can see in it? You can try it. Come on. Join your heels and open your toes. Now tell me, which shape you can see in it? Yes, it is V shape. Now you can imagine the floor pattern at my friend's veranda. Children, I also have a brick pattern in my house. In my house, I have a garden. In garden, I have lots of flowers, some vegetables also. I have two partition or kyaris. Two kyaris for flower. As a boundary of these, I have placed bricks on the edge of these kyaris. We make small kyaris for the flower, yes or no? I have also made such kyaris. And as a boundary of these kyaris, I have used bricks. Half of brick is dug inside the soil. I dug the soil along the edges of kyari and dug half the brick inside the soil. Now, triangular portion of brick is visible. Half the brick is visible and half the brick is dug in soil. It looks very attractive. Some of my friends asked me how I made this. I told them it is very easy. Just dug half brick inside the soil and tilt it slightly. We have to slightly tilt the brick so that brick above the soil looks like a triangle. Children, do you have a garden in your home? You can make this pattern in garden with the help of elders. For you, I am repeating the pattern so that you can listen it more carefully and make it. Along the edge of kyaris, first we dig soil. And in this soil, we put bricks. And after that, we tilt the bricks in such way The upper portion of brick above the soil looks like a triangle. It is very easy and looks beautiful. You can also make it easily. So children, you can try this, but not alone. You can take help of your mother, father, or someone who can do it for you. You just guide him or her and he will make beautiful pattern for you. Student, have you seen any floor pattern with bricks? Imagine that floor pattern. Yes, I am sure that you have seen many more beautiful patterns. Children, you have also seen bricks pattern on walls. Have you seen any net or jali? Have you seen any net or jali pattern on parapet wall or coping wall of houses or buildings? Parapet wall is a low wall along the edge of roof, balcony or a bridge. You must have seen jali pattern on parapet walls. Do you know why these jalis or nets are made in parapet walls? Think, why we made jali or net design in walls? Yes, these makes house or building beautiful. You are absolutely correct. By making jalis or net, we make our house beautiful. And apart from making the building beautiful, through these jali, fresh air and sunlight can come. We can enjoy sitting in fresh air, or sunlight can come through these jali. In my school, there are many nice looking jali patterns on walls. Do you also want to know about these? Okay, student, I am telling. Listen carefully. In one design, there are 4 vertical jalis and 2 horizontal jalis. Again, 4 vertical jalis and 2 horizontal jalis, and so on. Listen, I am repeating the pattern. There are 4 vertical jalis and 2 horizontal jalis. Again, 4 vertical jalis and 2 horizontal jalis, and so on. Can you imagine the pattern? It looks like which English alphabet? 4 vertical jalis and 2 horizontal jalis. Again, 4 vertical jalis and 2 horizontal jalis. Come on, tell me. Yes, you are right. It looks like letter H, capital H of English alphabets. In another pattern, we have 5 jalis. Yes, student, our school building has many wall patterns with these jalis. In this pattern, there are 5 jalis. 4 jalis at corner and 1 jali at the center. Imagine a square. It has 4 corner. How many corner a square has? Yes, it has 4 corners. वन जाली एट ईच कॉर्नर एंड वन जाली एट द सेंटर. इट लुक्स वेरी ब्यूटिफुल. वी ऑल्सो हैव अनदर पैटर्न मेड अप ऑफ ट्वेल्व जालीज. इट हैज सिक्स जालीज स्लोपिंग अपवर्ड एंड सिक्स जालीज स्लोपिंग डाउनवर्ड. इफ यू ज्वाइन फिंगर्स ऑफ योर हैंड एंड मेंटेन अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ अराउंड 30 सेंटीमीटर बिटवीन एल्बो. यस, यू कैन ट्राई दिस. ज्वाइन फिंगर्स ऑफ योर हैंड एंड मेंटेन अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ अराउंड 30 सेंटीमीटर्स बिटवीन एल्बोज. इट विल लुक्स लाइक सिमिलर टू दैट पैटर्न. सिक्स जालीज स्लोपिंग अपवर्ड एंड सिक्स जालीज स्लोपिंग डाउनवर्ड. नाउ कैन यू टेल मी विच इंग्लिश अल्फाबेट हैज रिजेंबलेंस विद दिस पैटर्न. थिंक. यस, यू आर राइट. इट लुक लाइक इन्वर्टेड वी शेप. यू ऑल आर जीनियस. थम्स अप फॉर यू ऑल. चिल्ड्रन, हैव यू सीन सच जालीज एनीवेयर? इमेजिन अबाउट द डिजाइन. इमेजिन अबाउट द डिजाइन एंड विच डिजाइन यू लाइक द मोस्ट. यू कैन मेक सच डिजाइन इन योर नोटबुक आफ्टर दिस प्रोग्राम गेट्स ओवर. डियर चिल्ड्रन, we are continuously talking about bricks and bricks pattern, brick design. You may be thinking how these bricks are made, don't you? Now we will learn how bricks are made. Children, you may have seen large chimneys while going in a bus or train, you have also seen these chimneys near your villages, where you can also see thousands of bricks. That place is called a kiln, where bricks are made. For making bricks, first we dug the soil from earth and mix it with water, and then we gave cuboid shape to it using a tray. After that, it hardened by drying in air and under sunlight. And at last, we bake bricks in chimneys. Yes. First, we dug the soil from earth and mix it with water. Then we gave it a brick shape, a cuboid shape, using a tray. After that, it hardened by drying in air under sunlight. And at last, we bake bricks in chimneys. Dear student, we have talked enough about bricks. Now, let's talk about you and your image. No, not about how good you are. I know you are very good. But this time, we are talking about your mirror image. You must have seen mirrors and do a lot of things in front of mirror. When you stand in front of a mirror, have you noticed your mirror image? What does it do? If you are combing your hairs, what your mirror image do? Yes, it also combs hair. Tell me children, is that possible? You are doing something and mirror image doing something else. No, it never happens. One thing I want to share. Children, have you noticed? When you raise your right hand, your mirror image raise left hand. When you hold your left ear, your mirror image hold right ear. Have you noticed it? Isn't this interesting? If you have a mirror in the room, you can try this. Raise your right hand, your mirror image will raise its left. It is very interesting. I want to ask one thing. If you place alphabet A, capital A. If you place alphabet A written on a paper in front of the mirror, does the mirror image look same or different? Yes, dear children, it looks same. But what about B, alphabet B, capital B? Will it look same or different? If we place alphabet B written on a paper in front of mirror, does the mirror image look same or different? Yes, it looks different. In mirror, you will see mirror image of alphabet B. You can try this for other alphabets and numbers. I am sure you will enjoy it. That's all for today. Let's note down some activities which you can do at home. First point, student. Draw mirror image of capital alphabets A, B, D, H, G, P, and T. You can note down in notebook. We have to draw mirror image of capital alphabets A, B, B for Bombay, D, D for Delhi, H, H for Hyderabad, G, G for Goa, P, P for Punjab, and T, T for Tamil Nadu. Next, what you can do is, you can also draw mirror image of numbers like number 4, 6, 9, and 0. Can I ask you a question? Does the mirror of image of 0 look same or different? Mirror image of 0 looks same or different? Yes, children, I know you are genius. You are right. Mirror image of 0 looks same. Draw a floor pattern. We have discussed many floor pattern with bricks like V-shape pattern, pattern in which bricks are arranged in sequence in particular order. 3 bricks vertically and then 3 bricks placed horizontally. Dear children, you have also seen these floor pattern in your school or at home or in your colony or village. You can draw any floor pattern with your imagination. I know you can do it, and I am sure that you will enjoy it. I know you are very creative and imaginative. You can draw two jali design at your home. Next activity. In this activity, draw a brick. You have seen a brick. Now you have to draw it in your notebook. Try to imagine the brick and draw it. Children, also note down how many faces a brick have. Do you know how many faces a brick have? Do you play Ludo or Snake and Ladder? In this game, you have a dice. How many faces a dice have? Can you get a 7 on the dice? Yeah, I am joking. We can't get a 7 on the dice. We can get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. We can only get 6 number, any of the 6 number on dice, because it has 6 faces. Now you can tell how many faces a brick have. Just note it down in your notebook after drawing of a brick. That's all for today. I hope you enjoyed it. We will meet again with some new concept and new activities. Goodbye, children. Stay safe, stay healthy, and always obey your parents. Eat healthy food and also do some studies.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants Meenakshi Kukreti and Tanu Gupta. Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.